Hey everybody, welcome back. Today's interview will be a bit different. You can already tell probably. It will be in English because today's guest is from Germany. Ich kann auch ein bisschen Deutsch sprechen, aber mein Englisch ist viel besser. So we will have this interview in English. Down here on the desktop version or up here on the mobile version, you have the CC button. You can activate from there the Romanian subtitles if you want to. I met today's guest a couple of years ago at a race. We really bonded and then, I don't know, we kept in touch. Before we meet today's guest, if you haven't so far, I would like you to subscribe to my channel and click on the bell so you'll find out when I upload a new video. Let's start. Hey!
Hey, Peter!
How are you? Ce faci?
Bine, bine! Mulțumesc!
Okay.
Nice to be on your channel, man.
Yeah, it's an honor for me. It's great to have you. So we can do this in Romanian, after all.
Putem să încercăm? No, but my Romanian really sucks.
Okay,
unluckily.
We're gonna continue this in English as we started it. First of all, introduce yourself. Who are you?
So, my name is Felix, I'm 25, from the south of Germany, and I started to study medicine here like 5.5 years ago.
Okay, so the date and place of birth is?
I was born in December.
In December.
1995, Germany.
And Germany, you should visit Germany. I've went there a couple of times. I can't wait to go back, but now it's hard with all the restrictions.
Yeah.
What is your profession?
So, as I said, I'm studying medicine, and in summer I'll be done, and then I'll probably start doing orthopedics and sports medicine if everything goes well.
Well, good luck with that.
Thank you, man. Sounds really nice.
Why is that nice? Because I don't know any orthopedic sports medicine doctors, you know.
Yeah,
I only know orthopedic doctors and kinetotherapy. Yes, I don't know how to say that in English.
Kinetotherapy.
But I don't know any sports medicine doctors, so this is really great. What are your hobbies, Felix?
So I'm basically running most time of the day when I'm free. I run. Also last year I started to do road cycling, which is also amazing hobby because you can reach so much more distance and go out more. And besides this, like normal people, meeting friends, cooking, just chilling, having a good time besides medicine, because it's really time-consuming.
I bet it's time-consuming. I've only heard about it. I don't know if I want to know, but I think I would do the same as well. I would take all my time off if I could, if I had a schedule that crowded.
True, but also running is so good to get your head free of it and just chill and put every energy you have into it.
That's exactly the same as I feel, so I can vouch for that. When and how did you start it to run?
So basically I started around 10 years ago running, but it was more like doing it once a week or once every 2 weeks. And then I got to Cluj, and I signed up for the, I think, Fatjet Winter Trail, and it was so amazing to run through the snow, and I was really motivated from then on. Signed up for the Wizz Air Half Marathon without proper training in 2018, I think it was, and it really catched me, and I was so motivated, and from then on I started to run every day and also got training plans and was motivated with Instagram and all the communities around, and also motivated other people. Yeah, that's basically it.
So basically you started to run after you signed up for a race for fun, and then you just fell in love with running.
Yeah,
more or less.
That's true. And also in Cluj, it's so amazing because there's so many races all around in Hoya and Fatjet on the road here.
We're pretty lucky with this part.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. What objectives or goals did you manage to achieve in running and sports?
So I raced so many beautiful races. Finished 2 years ago in Berlin my first marathon in 3 hours 28 minutes. Also last year, so many people have been demotivated by the corona crisis, and I just kept on training for myself and also finished a half marathon in 1:27 and like a 10k race in 37 minutes, and so it really kept me motivated. Last year I also bought my road bike and I cycled in 5 days like 850 kilometers to Vienna. I tried to come to Cluj, but unfortunately I hadn't enough power, but still.
Well, it's hard without a proper training.
Yeah, so. And also sitting like so many days.
Yeah, I know.
It's hard. And also like 2 years ago, I was part of a race we organized in Cluj, which was like a donation race for the hematology clinic here in Cluj. And we collected some money for it, and it was super fun that way to help somehow also with running.
Yeah, that sounds really nice. Those are some great accomplishments given the fact that the last 1.5 years we are in some sort of a lockdown. So
yeah, it's so sad.
Kudos for those.
Thank you, man.
So you've mentioned that you started some running plans.
Yes.
At the moment, do you have a running plan?
Yeah, I'm I'm in middle of a training for 1 hour 18 half marathon, but let's see, it's pretty ambitious for me at least. So yeah, let's see how it goes. I'm super motivated, but you never know.
That's great. I mean, 118, it's not easy to do. I have a 121 and I fought for it like hell. And how does your plan look like? I mean, an overview.
So it's basically between 70 and 100 kilometers a week. A long run on Sunday always. Mm-hmm. Interval session Wednesday. Most of the times I do it here in the stadium with some Romanian guys and a trainer, which is super motivating because they're all faster than me and it's really pushing forward. Yeah, and besides this, I have some runs on my lactate threshold and some easy runs to fill up the kilometers.
Yeah, exactly. So as you can probably tell, this is what most of my invites said about the training plan. So we have the intervals, we have the threshold, that's the tempo run, then the long run in the weekend most of the time, because then is the moment when you have more time to spare.
And it's basically so easy because the structure is most of the times the same, but still some people think like that there has to be a magic recipe how to get faster and better, but you just have to follow these steps.
Yeah, you have to follow these steps and adapt them to yourself,
to your pace,
but more or less they're the same. Okay, so we've heard about your running plan. Do you have a nutrition or hydration plan overall or during the race or something like that?
So overall not. I'm just trying to eat all the time because I really burn so many calories.
And
I'm taking some supplements. I implemented CBD oil and felt like a little better recovery. And after long runs and intervals, sometimes I take a protein shake to give the muscles again some proteins. And during the race, it's like everybody does some carbohydrate gels, but nothing specific or too scientific about it.
Okay. You're basically doing what almost everybody does, more or less.
Yeah.
Nothing special.
No magic
behind it. Yeah. Most of us do the same. What kind of running shoes do you use and why?
So before, I really was in love with Nike for tempo runs and the fast runs with the Zoomfly, the Vaporfly, and lately the Nike Tempo Next Percent. And for the easy runs, I was using Brooks or 361 Degrees. But now I got involved in like an influencer ambassador team of On.
Okay.
Running, which is like a Swiss running brand. I just started with this brand. Maybe you can see here, I have like, it's the On Cloudflow. It is like a light shoe for also faster runs. And I'm really curious to try the carbon fiber shoe of them, which is the On Cloud Boom, but let's
which is a response to the Nike's Vaporfly and the Next Percent and whatnot.
It's so nice that like all the running brands are now, because Nike started, and every brand now tries to improve it even more.
Yeah, that's true. But I wanted to say that you're the first one of my invitees who's using On.
Yeah,
that's how you pronounce it, right?
Yeah, I think so.
On Cloud. Their soles look like clouds if you look at them. Really interesting.
It's an interesting way of cushioning something new, which like nobody does except of On, but it really feels different, but really nice.
I'm gonna ask you in a couple of months to see if you're still in love with them.
Yeah,
you're probably in the beginning trying them still out.
Yeah, and probably it's the same for you. It's always nice like to get your hands on something new
and
something different and try and compare it to the other things.
As I said a couple of times, I'm still in search for some race shoes. I'm gonna have to try out some because I only have heavy shoes.
Yeah?
Yeah, I only
never
have heavy
tried
shoes.
Like the Vaporfly or...
No, never. I think I'm gonna buy a pair of Nikes or
it was
something from Adidas.
Just released like last week, I think, the second version. So
I really wanna run a fast marathon, so I'm gonna need all the help I can get.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, so Felix, what kind of gadgets do you use for running or for sports?
Okay, so most importantly, I have the Garmin Fenix 5S still. I think it was released 4 years ago, but it's still an amazing sports watch. Then I have for my phone always a bag to keep it. Sometimes I also film during my runs. I have a 360 camera from Insta360. I think it's also a nice gadget. The Garmin heart rate monitor is really good too. I mean, probably nobody is using those running dynamics, but it's so fun to have it all on.
I love them as well.
Yeah, you're the same. Okay, and for recovery, I have a foam roll, probably like most runners at a time. Massage gun, which also really helps to loosen up the tight muscles. Yeah, I think that's basically it.
Well, that's something. Yeah, that's more than most use. So what are the most important things that have improved your running?
It's following a training structure, which we mentioned before, because I was so long training, just how I felt, most of the time running the same pace. Also here in the stadium to run intervals with the Romanian guys, which is amazing. And signing up for races, getting motivated, setting goals, setting new goals all the time to like stick to it and get better and better every day.
As you can probably tell, 90% of my invitees who pointed out that having a training plan is the best thing that can improve your running.
True. So even it's sometimes so hard to follow it, especially after like drinking something or and then having a long run and a cycling session the same day.
Yeah, exactly.
But it is what it is.
Yeah. Okay, so how do you manage to integrate running in your everyday life?
Basically, it's easy for me because running is so important to me that I always will find time for it. And at the moment, we are having online classes, so I often go just taking the lecture into my ear and run a little to just have the audio input, which is nice. Mm-hmm. But I also have a lot of holidays where I can run the whole day or like normal people in the evening after university. So there's always some time if you really want to do it.
I bet you don't have too much spare time with all your classes and being always at the hospital or more or less always.
It's true, but somehow it also changed in the first years. We had even more university and I was studying really a lot, and then the studying part went a little down and the running part went up, so it just equilibrated somehow.
Yeah. That's great that you can manage to combine them.
I don't want to miss running.
Yeah, I don't want either, so yeah. I can totally understand you. Okay, so we're down to the last question. What are your plans or objectives for the future in running and sports?
So this year I'm really trying to get the sub 120 half marathon, and I have the Chicago marathon up in October, which you already ran, which you can see on the shirt. Yeah, and I want to run this in 2:45. I'm really trying
2:45
to achieve this goal, but let's see how it goes. And then in the near future or the next years, probably as you, I want to finish the six biggest major marathons. Yeah, and
that's top on my list.
And in life, like as I said, I want to become a sports medicine or sports doctor, and to just support other runners, other sportsmen to achieve their goals, have less injuries and be fit. Like when I started studying medicine, I didn't have a clue what I want to do later, and with running, like the combination of the hobby and the medicine, somehow I found it really interesting, and I really want to do this now as profession and combine this.
This is really great that you found something that you really love and you can combine it with your job. This is awesome.
True.
So best of luck with all of these, all of
you,
your objectives and everything. Hope to see you again at races, because that's how we see each other most of the time.
It was nice when we met at a race, a trail race, I think, and you were explaining something about the nature and the hills and the stuff, and guided me through the race, which I was not fit enough for.
Yeah, I remember that at that moment I was a lot fitter, but now things have changed and it's the other way around. But you never know where the future will get you, so we shall see. Best of luck with that 2:45 marathon.
Thank you, man.
And with that 1:18 half.
I'm excited what will come.
A lot of work has to go into that.
Yeah, and let's hope that races will be possible somewhere this year or next year.
Probably next year, but we shall see. I hope you enjoyed today's interview. I would like to invite you to like, share and subscribe my content, because it helps me a lot. See you next time in the next video, in the next vlog. Bye bye, everybody. Bye.
See you. Thank you.